Hey folks, I'm Kid Silver Sacks here, and I am back with some space engineers. I had a little bit of a, well, I shouldn't say a little bit of a stream. I had a two-hour stream earlier today in which I was messing around with my new mega build. And if you're not familiar with my mega builds, well, here's one of them. This is my Enterprise D. I think there's something I needed to change on it, too. Oh, yeah, the coloring. Yes. Let's, it was 255. There we go. Okay. Maybe I'll re-upload this. Eh? That's already done. Oh, because that is on. That's why. Alright. Anyway. So, I have my Enterprise D, which is my, one of my main, mega builds, and of course it's fully functional battle station. But I'm working on a super star destroyer. It's kind of getting there. I don't know what it's going to end up looking like at the in the end, but it's going to have like the little tail off the back. I'm going to try to model it a little bit like Vader's Super Star Destroyer Executor or Executor or whatever he calls it. Yeah, that's about it. So I think I'm going to go ahead and continue to work on this. And I know Malenkor is in game. He might actually join us a little bit later as well. So let's see. I've been working on getting the slopes just right. Perhaps, let's see, we've got three there, three, four. This one's going to be a little bit bigger, right here. We're gonna pop it out one more, I think. And we're also going to raise height just a little bit. I believe I have it as 6 ship units. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There we go. Alright, we will bump it up one. Oh, didn't want that color. Oops. The, what's the original? Is that the original color? That looks like it. And we're going to use that one. Okay. And it's going to bump up basically a half block. Because each time I raise the center, it's by a half block. So half block there, and then that should go on for the next 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. going to expand this out one more. And, one of these half ramps in. There we go. Although that should only go for 3. Yep. Hey, how's it going?
Hey.
And we got Malenkor in. All right.
You live already?
I am live.
Nice. I will be there in just a moment.
Sounds good. Hey, kill switch. Yeah, I'm feeling a little bit better. I was battling a nasty sore throat over the course of really the week. So I am feeling much better now. Not necessarily 100% though, but you know, that's maybe I'll be 100% in a couple days. I'm just kind of waiting for that time when it's... Maybe it's the weather. I have no idea. But yeah, thanks for asking. I do appreciate it. I'm gonna need a lot of thrusters. A lot of thrusters. Six is going to be... No, not that. Six is going to be there. There we go. Need my half block again. Oh yeah, it's a Super Star Destroyer that I'm building. And I know it sounds like it's easy as easy as like basically trying to make a piece of pie in space, but the angles, unless you have them right, it's gonna look awful. And I'm trying to get it so that it looks fairly decent. So we'll see where that leads us. So that's 3. Okay, so I think this is going to be a phase 5. Phase 5, what am I talking about? Hmm. acrobats for that. 3. Killswitch just got their new gaming headset. Nice, congrats. What'd you get? Version Tech G20. Never heard of it. Good, nice, nice. Oh, nice. Yeah, it's probably so. It probably is like an analog one. Has like a 3.5 millimeter jack on it. I'm assuming it probably does because you would probably need that in order to for it to be useful in like a multi-platform situation. Millimeter. Nice. That's not too bad. Most of the gaming headsets I know are 50 or 55, but you know, if you want to save your hearing, might not be a bad option to go with the 40. All right, let's see. All right, all right. So now it goes one more out. So let's get the half block going. Oh no, that didn't. That was only two. Nope. Take that away. Yeah, that's 3 units long there. Okay. Okay, and it's gonna go out one. So kill switch go. We got Dr. Dave Tech going. Yo, hey, how's it going, Dr. Dave? Sorry, I didn't see your message until now. When's my next giveaway? 20,000 hours from now? I don't know. I haven't really thought about it, to be honest. How's everyone doing this evening? Hopefully well. It's a half block, so let's see, I need the ramp right here. Oh wait, no, not right there. Thank you. Man, I gotta get used to the rotation a bit better. Is that a five? That's a five, probably. Yep. Yeah, I haven't played Left 4 Dead 2 in a long time. That's a pretty good game. It's a little aged, to be honest. Not bad, though. There we go. Just basically trying to get the overall shape down. It's up a bit. Hey, Medieval, how's it going? He goes, aged like a fine wine, or me? I don't know how to answer that without being offensive to anything. Okay, I need the six. More like aged milk. Ouch! Jesus! You know, Medieval is our friend. Just FYI. Let's see, 8. There we go. Then that. There we go.
I don't think your platform is large enough.
For what?
Anything.
Make it bigger.
Probably going to.
Okay. I mean, not only that, but I've expanded it, but I didn't take the time to expand it that much. Medieval. I think he was talking about the game. I see how you are. Jeff Dunham? Yeah, I know Jeff Dunham. That's, he's pretty funny. He's the guy with the puppets, right? All right, later, Killswitch, aka Yoshi. We'll see ya. So is this the reworked over here?
Correct.
So it has four grinders instead of six, huh?
Correct. Hmm. I'm actually redoing it again.
What's wrong with it?
I've got no proper way to sort out stone and just eject it.
Oh.
Nobody wants stone. Stone it. Right. At this point.
I bumped that one up, and that was 9. I'm going to do that again to this one. And that's going to be... this one. Nope. Didn't want to do that. I don't know why I did that. That was dumb. There we go. What am I missing? Oh. All right. One. By the way, folks, if you're new to the channel, feel free to say hi in the live chat. And, smash up that subscribe button. Alright. Wait, what the? How are there enemies? I turned all of them off, I thought.
Well, apparently you thought wrong.
Huh? Oh, why is that happening? Moogly, he needs some milk. All right. I wonder if I could rename that. I don't want to respawn. Alright. I wanted to save it. Because I want to make sure that nothing's going to happen to it. Or if it does, that that at least I could get it back.
Yeah. Do that, because when I said, oh, crap, earlier.
Uh-huh.
My ship freaked out and half of it exploded and I had to rebuild it again.
Oh, God.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so make sure you get a backup.
that's the first three. All right. I think I'm going to add another 15. There we go. So how's it going, Moog? What's up, man? By the way, ice cream was a good choice. Yep. Gotta take a break. Two, that's two. Each one of those sections, two. That slope is two, though. That's always been a two. Just going over the bizarre measurements of this. Because you kind of have to. You want it to look halfway decent. It's a five. There we go. Much better. Yeah, I'll be able to get in there and kind of hollow out the inside a little bit more. Street Race Dave goes, look, a space peanut. What? Alright, that's three. Another three. Push that out a bit more. Oh, is that, Mo-Man? Or Mo-Man or whatever? From The Simpsons? Ew, it's like kissing a peanut. Hans Mollman, that's right. Mollman in the morning. Oh, Joe Dirt. Yeah. Okay. Oh, I think it needs to be bigger. I mean, after all, it is a superstar destroyer. Another episode of How I Live My Life in Constant Pain. I'm 35 years old. Boom. Says. All right. Side of this thing is gonna be pretty flat. Thank you, Moog. It needed one of those. I guess it was a that's what she said moment, but hey, can you do a two-dimensional grid? Can you do that in the game? Like,
what do you mean?
Like fill in two-dimensional and not just a lengthwise? You know what I'm saying?
I think you can, but
I forgot. Yeah. So that goes 1, 2, 3, 3. 1, 2, 3. There we go. Thank you, Dave. Your contribution has been noted. Mike. Yes. So Dave, how's the drive back? currently in the mountains in Chattanooga. Oh. Ooh. How's version 3.0 coming along?
Getting ready for automated testing right now.
Nice. It's not going to start, like, eating the asteroid that our thing is on, right?
No, I'm going to go to a different one.
Okay.
So you see how compact it is?
Yeah, I thought it looked pretty good.
It has more storage than the other one.
Yeah, because you snaked everything around it. Like, you use so much of the space, so much of, I mean, the body is basically conveyor, right?
Mm-hmm. Conveyor and pipes, yep.
It's impressive. Wow. Hydrogen thrusters out the back, huh?
Hydrogen thrusters all over.
Oh, yeah.
There's an H2 generator in it as well, so all I gotta do is gather some ice and it'll start making H2.
Beautiful.
Keep it running. Just going through and setting up the programming. Seriously, where's that LCD at? Oh, it's on the There it is.
Let's see. That height, 123, 123, that's 9. And it's time for a new one. Ice. Uh-oh. Ooh, that was weird.
I just compiled some code, sorry.
Oh, okay. I'm like, oh god! Good thing I saved.
No, that was just a little glitch because I compiled code.
Gotcha.
Okay. Alright. Worked right the first time. Excellent. Okay, so the only thing I have left to do is need to program. configure something else. Let's see.
So some of you guys are probably wondering, like, am I going to have enough room on the inside of this thing? And the answer is yes. I'm going to be getting rid of the structural skeleton on the inside of the ship once the main hull is pretty much complete. And that's going to free up a lot of space. A lot of space. So we're gonna be able to like put a bunch of ships in here. It'll look pretty cool. And yes, Moog, mice create hydrogen.
What?
Well, you were saying something about ice creating hydrogen?
Yes.
This is going to be much, much bigger here.
Okay, I've got a copy of it now.
Oh, wait. No, not what we need to do. That. Oh. It runs squeaky. Yes. Bye.
automated setup going.
That's better.
Why is the stone getting into the cargo containers? It shouldn't be getting into the cargo containers. What the hell?
I'm not gonna lie, that thing is getting horrifyingly long.
Mm-hmm.
I like it. So did you find out what was making it collect stone?
Not yet, actually.
Hmm.
I may have just figured it out.
Oh?
Yeah, bad placement of a, No? No, that wouldn't do it. Maybe. couldn't do it. I have no clue how it's getting into the system.
I don't know, perhaps like a code is broken or something.
Because I have it specifically broken off so that it doesn't do that. Alright. Let's tear into it, see what's going on.
Tear it up, man.
So it all comes into the center, as it should, which is then routed based on blacklists. And remove you. Not you, damn it. Okay, so there should be no possible way for it to actually get in there, unless it's just completely ignoring my blacklists.
Really, that's probably what it's doing.
Okay, I think it has something to do with my filters. I think I've got them mixed up. There's no good way to identify them. So, what we're going to do, remove the two blacklists. Or the two whitelists. And we're gonna label. Ah, there it is. That's our issue. I had them turned around. A blacklist stone on that. Name it. Set up, so now we can reinstall the other sorters. This time, knowing which ones they are. Usually a good thing, right?
Yeah. But.
Alright. You're going to get a lag spike here in a few minutes because I'm going to reinstall the the script, so I have to compile it again.
Hmm. 3, 3. More.
Here comes the lag spike.
Okay.
Set.
So much work on this. Mike Spike?
Wasn't me.
Oh, never mind. It was just my head.
Is working properly.
Excellence. Most excellence.
It works really well.
Good.
Like, I'm carving out basically a square that we can make into a base if we wanted to.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. I can specify how big of a hole it is, like, from corner to corner, mm-hmm. and how deep it is. Automatically return to base to refuel
mm-hmm.
and to unload in case it's picked up anything aside from stone.
Oh, cool. Because
right now it's got a filter just to kick stone out the back.
Nice.
And the only only thing I need to add now is some ore detectors to it, as well as some lights.
No, do not delete that. Yeah.
Yeah, what?
We got a little chop there. Two, three, four, five. Five section. Oh, I love symmetry mode. If it weren't for that, I probably wouldn't be doing mega builds.
You know you can do dual modes of symmetry, right?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
It just wouldn't work
on
this.
That's how I built this thing.
Right. I mean, on that thing, you could technically build one thing and it duplicates it three times, right?
See what she does. She's about to finish the mining operation. Mining operation has been completed. Let's see what the screen says. It says returning. Looks like we are returning to base.
That's a good thing.
Yep, flying to dock area. And it should automatically dock on top of it.
Good.
Okay, it's obviously lining up dock, and it just docked.
What did it dock to, by the way?
The station here.
Oh, nice.
And
now the question is, if we equip the Enterprise, will it go in through the docking bay doors and do that?
Yep.
We should do that.
It'll absolutely do that.
We should do that. Now, whatever adjustments you want to make on the Enterprise, feel free to do so, and I'll make a. We'll save it as a secondary blueprint, like a mining Enterprise or something. 5. Okay. So I'm standing on the back strut of the frame of the ship.
Okay.
And I'm a little bit more than 3/4 of a kilometer away from the station.
Jesus.
Yeah. By the time I'm done with this thing, it's probably going to be 1 kilometer long. You know what the funny thing is?
Hmm.
That is about the average size of an Imperial class Star Destroyer. And I believe, I can't remember how many of the, like, I think a Super Star Destroyer is about 25 times the length of one of those. I'm not sure though, but it sounds about right. Where'd you go?
I'm still here.
I'm just saying that I lost your signal. Oh, there you are. That looks nice.
Thank you.
That looks really good.
I boxed it in so to keep any loose
debris and stuff, yeah.
Debris from getting in there and bouncing around and stuff. Yeah, it automatically ejects stone out of these little ejectors here. There's 4 of them, so 1 for each drill. It's not super efficient, but it does the trick.
Let's see, it's 3 blocks high. 3 big blocks, right?
Yeah.
Or maybe it's a little bit shorter than that, because...
No, it's not high. It's 3 blocks wide. It's about 2 1/4 tall.
Ooh. So technically, we could fit like 2 or 3 of those in the Enterprise.
Probably. I need to make a copy of this real quick.
Oh, yeah, good idea. Good thinking.
No, I've been making backups as I go.
Yeah, I should do that. Same thing.
But I'm pretty happy with this, actually, so I may call this complete. And edit screenshot. We are.
How do you recopy something or re-save it?
If the name hasn't changed, you just hit create new from clipboard.
Hmm.
At least that's what I've been doing.
Gotcha.
You don't have to paste it. Once you've made the new blueprint, just hit escape and it'll go away.
Gotcha.
You want to see how this thing works, though?
Yeah, give me a second. Yeah. Weird. You cannot replace local blueprint while you have Steam Cloud turned on. What? Why? Why not? Fine, then I'll turn off Steam Cloud. Jeez. What a... Okay. So, you know how it's like not even close to being done? I've already got 13,516 blocks on this bad boy.
Jesus.
Yeah, I know, right? Do you want to see my... Okay, I'll come over and watch that thing, and I was going to see if you wanted to check out the contour. Where'd you go?
I'm still here.
By the...
You're flying right at me.
Am I? Oh.
I think my radio thing is off, and I don't know how to turn it back on. Two seconds.
Okay.
Gonna bother me now.
Is mine on though?
Yeah, I can see you.
Because yours was on like a couple minutes ago. No, there it is.
Yeah, it's O. O is the key for that.
Oh.
Anyways.
Oh, it's magic.
So if you come where I'm sitting here and you look where the cockpit's looking.
Yeah.
There's a screen.
Yeah.
That's a live interactable menu.
Nice.
If you jump in the pilot seat, one, two, and three are going to control it. One is up, two is down, and three is apply.
Oh.
You see it moving on the screen?
Yeah.
I can see it moving on the screen.
Yeah. I like it.
Yeah. So basically the first one is when you're docked, you set that as your home.
Yeah.
And you can record the path to get outside. So, say you have to go through an airlock or something, you can record that path to go through the airlock, and then you stop it.
Yeah.
Then you fly the ship to the area where you want to mine, and then you do the setup mining job.
Okay.
You can go ahead and click that. We won't confirm anything, but...
Okay,
so go ahead and hit 3 on it to go into the menu.
Okay. Yep.
And you can go down and you can set the width, the height, and the depth.
Dang. Not bad. And you can just type into the integers?
No, you have to use apply on it. So go ahead and hit 3 on it.
On the width?
On any of them, yeah. Whatever you want. You'll see the values change.
Oh, there's a plus.
That's the width minus and the width plus.
Nice.
And when you're ready to give it a go, you can just hit start new job. It's gonna start doing stuff when you
hit
that.
Back.
There's no way to get out. You can't get out of this menu. But there's a quick way to do it. So just hit the start new job, and then immediately hit 3 because it'll stop. There you go.
All right. Cool.
Yeah.
I like that.
It's completely automated. It now has an ore scanner. It also has lights.
Are you going to upload that to the workshop?
I more than likely am, yes.
Nice. We should make collections. Like, you should make these minor things, and then I'll make the capital ships that freight them around. Okay, well, now here's the biggest question.
Mm-hmm. Can it fit?
Yes.
All right. Let's find out, shall we?
May not.
I think it will.
We'll see. We shall see. Let's do the big hangar underneath first.
Okay.
Let's see. Remote access. For some odd reason, I'm not able to... Oh, you know what? It's because I don't own the ship.
This actually might be kind of tight.
It might be. But
I think we can do it, actually.
Hold on, let me at least get in to the ship.
I'm just getting in position.
Okay.
Trying to get an idea if I'm going to be able to make it or not.
Well, and I should probably be in here to guide you the first time, at least, anyway. Wrong door. Need to go downstairs. Yeah.
Oh, it's totally doable.
Is it?
It's real tight, but it's totally doable.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, that'll work. You've got. Ease it in, ease it in. Oh yeah. Let's yeah. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Stop. This doesn't have landing gear, does it?
No, it doesn't.
That could be a
Guess
problem.
It's not complete. Guess it's not complete. Guess I'll have to figure out a way to throw some landing gear in there that are recessed.
Unless I recess landing gear on the actual capital ship.
You could do that as well.
Anyway, go ahead and leave the leave that and take a look at. Well, not leave here, but I'm just saying, like, what do you think? We could probably fit three in here.
Oh, easily. We could put more on the roof as well.
Well, here's what I was thinking. Let's go upstairs just for a second, because you know how the upstairs hangar, the doors are small?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the doors are small.
I actually think it would fit in there, too.
No, it will. Hold on, I'll show you what I'm talking about here for a second. But, what we could do is we could put like an ore docking station right here and have this whole area right here be like ore storage.
We absolutely could put a refinery in and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let me change this to we own it. I mean, and this thing is set up to be used in survival mode too. Just by the way.
Godly expensive to make.
Okay, yes. But we could do a case scenario of like we just spawn one in and say we had it to begin with, you know. We just have to maintain it. That is going to be the tricky part. Let's see what was going to be. Oh, it's K. Yeah, okay. Okay. Right, it belongs to us now. So that means that we can actually remote control the doors from the outside. Let's see if that works. Upper hangar doors closed. Aha. I don't know, what do you think? Do you think we should leave the lower bay for like fighters and shuttles and then the upper bay for mining, since we do have, since basically in the real Enterprise, that's like the cargo hold for like all the precious things on the ship is the one that's on the saucer.
I might have found a way to do landing gear.
Oh? Is it recessed? Oh, we put it on the side. Possibly?
Ta-da.
Oh. That's very nice. And it's on top and bottom, too.
Mm-hmm.
That is going to make things a lot easier. So, do you want to try putting in the top hanger? Control panel. Low hanger doors, close. Upper hanger doors, open. I'm just curious if we can fly it into this and how well it can maneuver over to the... It's got a... That's low clearance. Easy there, Chief. All right, let's lower. There we go.
I know. I'm just lining it up.
Yeah, buddy. There you go. Now, here's the thing. Hit, or I guess just see if you could pan rotate it. There you go. I wonder if you could get it in here. This would be an awkward place, but still.
Sorry, I'm fighting with the camera.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, you've got plenty of room on top, too. Okay, angle nose down. There you go.
And fight the camera more.
Of course. And you've actually got a lot of room to maneuver. I mean, hop out of that for a second. Look how much room you have to maneuver.
Oh, I can see it. I'm in third person.
Oh, okay.
You can't fly this in first.
That's true. Oh, yeah, because you're looking at a black screen.
Yep.
Close enough. Is it locked?
I haven't set it to auto lock, so... Group these. Okay, and groups and switch lock. It's unlocked at the moment.
You're bam, showing bam. Yellows. You're showing yellows, and your bam. Greens. Double greens. There we go. Look at that. That's beautiful. You could fit like two or three just in that little cargo bay over here.
Mm-hmm. And they've got a large amount of storage.
Oh, yeah.
Which is fantastic.
But I'm just saying, like, they're, like, think about all the space underneath our feet right now in the saucer, and the fact that we could probably put a lot of cargo, like, hookups in here, too.
The landing gear was a nice addition.
Mm-hmm. It needed it. Especially because, I mean, this is going to be something that we've got to freight around. Unless you somehow put a, like, a warp drive on it or something.
No.
I wish I could put a little bit more head clearance in this part of the hangar, but unfortunately...
The only downside is fighting the camera.
Yeah. A little bit lower. You're... Go, oh, God!
Oh! <Oops. laughs>
That'll buff right out.
What just happened? I've got no power.
Well, the front of your ship kind of exploded. Oh, there's power. Oh jeez, you lost, like, everything.
Well.
At least you saved it.
Fuck. Yeah. I lost my hydrogen, that's not good.
I mean, technically, couldn't you just use regular thrusters? That would...
I could, but they're not very powerful. Alright, I didn't save it with the landing gear, so I gotta redo the landing gear.
Well, that shouldn't be difficult. That was...
Done.
Oh, you've already done it?
Yeah, I've already finished. I've already repaired.
Dang.
Ta-da, it's back. Now, the only other thing I have to do is just reassign the groups. And... here. And... groups. And... switch lock. And there we are. Resave it now, so we don't have to worry about that. It's updated.
Nice.
It's a local blueprint only at the moment, so I can swap that around later.
Okay. Sounds good. I mean, that thing is awesome. I like it.
Completely automated. You set it and forget it.
It's like the Bronco Showtime. Just set it and forget it.
Here's the other thing you could also do. If you don't want to squeeze it through the door.
Yeah.
You got the nacelles.
Yeah, that's true.
You can totally just put connectors on the nacelles.
Oh, yeah.
And there's huge amounts of storage space in those.
That's true. Although, since those are weak points, we if we get like got shot on the warp nacelles, we don't want to lose all of our cargo. Because honestly, there's like a 2-block wide strut that's holding it on. That thing could get mowed pretty easily. But yes, absolutely.
I am happy with that.
Yeah.
that
it's pretty freaking works. It's pretty compact, man.
Yeah, it's... I'm happy I was able to get it so compact. This thing's got 6 medium containers.
Wow.
Yeah, 6 medium containers in there. 4 drills. Buttload of thrusters. It's got the H2 processor, so it'll make oxygen and hydrogen. Did not plumb the cockpit, though.
Hmm. Yeah. But I mean, like, it...
though it should be relatively straightforward to just...
I mean, it covers all bases.
Oh, yeah, I can totally do that.
I mean, the fact that we can actually fit it in through the hangar bays, I'm happy with
legit,
that.
It's legit, right?
Yeah. Well, and that was the biggest thing, is, like, obviously, this thing has to function with another ship. It has to co-function. It can't be by itself. So, like, we either are going to use the Enterprise or that mile-long catastrophe that I'm looking at. And actually, I'm getting kind of excited about, like, the fact that that thing is going to be usable in several hundred more hours of me working on it. Looks like we got some more viewers joining us. Hey guys, feel free to hit that subscribe button, like the video, follow on Twitch.
Okay, where's the H2?
We got a little miner right here too. I wonder if,
where?
Just over here, a little blue one, prefab. Did you not see them over here?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that.
Yeah, there's a builder, a miner, and a little fighter. Anyway, man, you gotta check out the ridiculousness of the Super Star Destroyer, especially towards the, well, as you get towards the back here.
It's oh, like, shit, I can plumb that right in. Sorry, 2 seconds.
Okay.
Like I'm gonna put oxygen into the cockpit.
Oh.
So in survival, you won't die.
Oh, yeah, that would, you know, something that would
usually
be good.
Pretty nice, yep. Right?
Uh-huh.
Oh, shit. The CD screen is going to cause an issue with that. Can't go about it that way, then. No, I can't do it. I can't do it with the current setup.
Well, think about it this way.
Have to make it, like, one block longer.
Longer is okay, though.
Yeah.
I mean, we could work with longer, just not wider or taller.
Yeah.
Well, wider would be okay. Okay. But I was just thinking, like, that thing cannot be any taller than it is. Otherwise, it's not getting in those hangar bays. I'd actually have to start making dual hangar bays where it's doors that open up on the, both the top and bottom. I'm going to do that with the Star Destroyer, but I'm not going to do that with the Enterprise. Because the Enterprise is like a super mini mega. This thing is, even though it's a Super Star Destroyer and it is a mini mega, it's bigger than the Enterprise. And we could do some better things with the doors. So, see what was Oh, I didn't. Okay. Two, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Wait, what in the world is going on here? Oh, this is where I needed to bump out. Okay. Eh. 10 or 5? One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. There should be a little bump right here. Did I miss one somewhere? That's a wedge. That's a... Okay. Nope. We're good. We are good. One.
All right, I'm back.
Two. Welcome back. Two, three, four, five. I was correct on my calculations. Yes. Need the half blocks.
I'm going to extend the nose one block.
You know, I was just thinking with the Superstar Destroyer.
Hmm.
There are a lot of big flat spots. You definitely have some external cargo deals on it, you know? So that the thing doesn't have to go inside the chip. Each and every time when it drops off, it just goes inside the ship when it returns from work. That one is 9 long, and then we are going to make frame this out a bit here.
Alright. So I've extended it and managed to get oxygen into the cockpit.
Sweet.
Now I just need to seal it all back up.
That is looking nice. Not what I wanted to do. Is that an asteroid causing a massive shadow? I guess it is. Weird.
Might catch a little bit of lag here in just a moment.
Okay. Oh man,
I just finished Why is it detecting two LCD panels? Did it really? It did.
Why?
It put it on twice. Here comes the lag.
Okay.
Should already be over.
I'll determine that. I didn't get anything.
Okay. And we're back online.
Nice.
And we've got oxygen in the cockpit. And it's one block longer.
Better one block longer than one block higher.
Perfect. Blueprint is saved.
Nice.
So where are you at?
In the back of the ship. 4, 5.
Ah, there you are.
What do you think?
It's big. I'm just concerned about where you're going to put your thrusters.
Everywhere. Because right now...
you're going to need them everywhere.
Well, right now, this is just the bare bones, like the skeleton. When I go back, they're like the whole side panel, like down the whole length of the ship, it's all going to be thrusters. Like, all these flat spots on the side of the ship, thrusters. Down the center, thrusters. Off the back, massive thrusters. I thought there was one that was... Do I have that one? Ooh.
Shit.
What?
I can't access the main base.
Oh, because it doesn't belong to you?
Nope.
Let me adjust that. Not a problem. Try it.
Yeah, I can access it now. Let's see if this thing is. It is not unloaded.
Alright, well, I might actually call the stream from here. Malenko and I are probably going to be doing some more work on our builds, and we'll come back to you in a bit sometime this weekend and update you on how the builds are going. Otherwise, make sure to say hi in the comment section below. Let us know if you want to see more creativity within Space Engineers, and yeah, we'll catch you in the next one. Thank you all for watching. Hit that subscribe button, follow button, like button. And if you don't like the videos, I guess you could just go to another channel. Anyway, have a good one. Peace out.